This is Richard from islandlimerick.com. We're here at the Young Social Innovators Speak Out at the Limetree, and I'm with none other than Lou Culhane from Create No Hate. He's right there, people, and we're getting ready to go up and speak at Young Social Innovators, and we're super excited. It's an amazing, amazing chance to fire young people's passion and change the world for good.
So I'd like to welcome to the stage Richard Lynch, presenter, producer, songwriter, actor, and creator of ILoveLimerick.ie. A fun fact, he's never a stranger in a person's company, and he's always with an entourage. So if you want to get your squad goals down, you need to look at Richard here. I'd also like to bring to the stage Luke Culhane, who's created No Hate video against cyberbullying.
Has gone viral, and a little fun fact about Luke is that he makes videos on YouTube. So I'll pass it over to the guys for a few quick words here. Thank you.
Hey, what's going on? Get over here. Wow, I've got to shake all this out. Pow, pow, pow. You know something? It's so. This is Luke Culhane, by the way. Can we give him a round of applause? Round of applause for the Young Social Innovators. We're here today to change the world. You know, I actually get nervous talking to the teenagers because you can be so cruel and you can be a really tough audience, right? That's true because I'm Richard Lynch, myoveLimerick.com, and I was a teenager once, and I grew up gay in Limerick, and in the 70s, I know, being gay is cool now, but it wasn't in the 70s.
I'm sorry to say.
But it's super cool now. And so I was really badly bullied, right? It was like, it was a horror story. For like a decade, I was abused and bullied. So what I did in my entire 20s was I didn't want to really face who I was, and I didn't want to really accept that I had any talent or creativity. So I just drank myself silly and did tons of drugs. And it does sound like fun, but if you're doing that to negate your pain and to take away your pain, it's really, really, really a horrible, ugly thing. What you should actually be doing is doing what Luke did, and is taking your creativity and creating something amazing to share with the world. Can I get an amen in here? Everyone on the dance, please. It's far more, anyone can go out and get a lanyard drunk. Anyone, like, I smoked weed for 25 years, and it gave me pink paradise, stupid. I'm off of weed 3 years, I'm off alcohol 14 years, but every day I struggle with addiction because I still don't like myself sometimes. So what I do to keep off crack is I just create. I create voraciously, like a maniac. I make pop music, I've written 2 horror movies, and I was very blessed. I lived in New York for 16 years, and my mom had a heart attack, and my dad was sick. So I came home in 2008, my boyfriend at the time, and I stayed here, and I produced Gay Pride in 2008. Can I give a round of applause to Gay Pride? To the LGBT community, and I called it Island Limerick, because I wanted it to be integrated and not segregated. And then I took the .com and I developed it to a YouTube channel. And over the last 8 years, I've been working voluntarily with a team of people to produce news stories, documentaries, and positive events about my beloved, bullied city, Limerick. Can we give Limerick a round of applause, please? And I actually have all my crew right there. They're all gorgeous girls to you. Can I give my gorgeous girls a round of applause, please? The point I'm trying to make, right, is that we're all in pain. It's not where you come from, it's where you're going. It's not your pain that makes you special. It's really, like a lot of people get on a river, get on a boat to cross a river, and then they don't want to get off the boat because they think being a victim makes them special. Being a victim doesn't make you special. Anyone can be the victim. It's about taking nothing and making something. Like, I love Limerick. We've never been funded, I've never been paid for it, I work 80 hours a week, I'm a workaholic, that's what I do, I work super hard, but I've got the opportunity. If you told me I was going to be writing a newspaper column for the last 6 years, I would have said you were tripping, and everyone would be a writer. If you told me I was going to be editing film, I would say to you, I did all of that out of necessity, and I learned organically, and you're all in a very amazing position, because any one of you can be a filmmaker now. You have an iPhone, you can make films. You have so many tools at your disposal to express your spirit, express who you are. You don't have to do it through hatred. You don't have to cyberbully. You don't have to turn to drugs or alcohol. You can actually take something and be conducive, and you can do something that's cathartic and healing. And you can help people. You can help the elderly. You can educate people about drugs. You can educate, say to people, bullying is not cool. You don't have to take your anger or your frustration at being a teenager or being a young person. You don't have to take it out on anyone else. Instead, you should own your beauty, love yourself.
Can I get an end for loving yourself, please? Am I over? Am I still going?
It is so vitally important to love yourself. Even coming here today, I was actually shaking myself because I was saying, oh my God, I have to get up in front of 300 teenagers and talk about, like, because I'm not really, you know, we're all the same as one another. Every single one of us. It's not our pain that makes us special. The only thing that makes us special is what we decide to do with who we are as individuals. You can't make excuses. Anyone can be an alcoholic. Not everyone can be inspired.
Can we give inspired a round of applause, please? You know what I mean? Don't make excuses. Don't take the shit out of everyone else. Actually do something. If you're in pain and you're upset about something,
I find like going out helping people for me has been the biggest blessing in my life. I love Limerick as a huge blessing. Just last night, I produced a launch. This 17-year-old girl in Leonelli, her sister died. She was 16 months old. She died of meningitis a year ago. In the last year, the 17-year-old girl, Leonelli, has helped raise 20,000 euros for acts of meningitis. And now she's producing a ball in the Greenhouse Hotel on April 16th. It's a sellout. She was on Live 95 yesterday. Not only that, she sings songs about social injustice, about cyberbullying, about teenage suicide, because all these things are real. The only way you're ever going to be able to deal with life is transmute your pain through creativity. And this is my big lead up into something very special. About a month ago, I got a phone call from my friend Claire Culhane. She's sitting right there. Can we give her a round of applause? She's a half-blind mother. She's 45 years of age. She's had five children and she looks amazing. I'm 44, by the way. So I don't believe it. Okay, so she calls me a month ago and she says to me, "Mommy, Luke, her son here, who is the bomb by the way, he makes videos and someone wrote on his YouTube channel that he's gay or wrote something horrible about it." So she called me up and she said, "Luke is really upset, someone's been writing horrible comments on his YouTube channel." So I said, "Put Luke on the phone to me." And I said, "Luke, what do you need to do? You're a filmmaker, you need to go out and you need to make a film about what you're experiencing right now. And you need to live your life in real time, and you need to do something to help people." So with the help of his godfather, Dermot, and his father, Dermot, they went out and they made a film called Create No Hate, and the film has been watched by, I think, over 250 million people on his YouTube channel, and millions of people all around the world. He's been on Sky News, he's been on Fox Television, he's been on UTV, he's been everywhere. And this guy is a 14-year-old kid. Are you videotaping me?
Yeah.
Is this live? Oh my God, this is amazing. Oh my God, I'm getting video content, great content. So this 14-year-old, now he's taking this hashtag, createnohate, and he just bought createnohate.ie.com, and he's creating a website that is going to be against all forms of hatred, not cyberbullying. And on that note, I want to introduce amazing filmmaker extraordinaire. Can you put your hands together and give a huge round of applause to Luke Culhane?
Oh my God, I'm going to film you now. I'm about to film him.
Now I'm a filmmaker. Look, kid.
Hi, my name is Luke Culhane and I've been doing YouTube for about a year now, and I've been doing games and that didn't work out, so I started doing vlogs and I've been getting bad comments, and I told my mum and then she let me talk to Richard, and he said to make a film about it. So the next day I emailed my godfather Dermot and he said he would come up the next day, and we got to planning, and after that day we spent about a week filming, and It took a week to make, and when we uploaded it, it went on Joe.ie, and then the Rubber Bandits tweeted about it, and then the next day it had about 50,000 views, and then it kept growing from there, and then I got to do interviews with like Sky News and Fox News, and it was fun, but there's still like bad comments on it, so we just blocked and reported the people that were making bad comments. And someone said, why don't you just turn off your screen? But that way the bullies would win, and it'd be unfair to stop doing what I like to do just because they want their own way. So I ignored that, and I just did what I wanted to do. I was just working out. Thanks.
Is that kid the bomb? Can we get on the phone?
Keep filming, Lou. Keep filming. This is broadcast quality.
The point we're trying to make is you don't need to be hateful, you don't need to be racist, you don't need to be xenophobic, you don't need to be homophobic. That's all 1993. No one gives a shit anymore. The best thing that you need to do is you need to be creative. That will take away all your pain. That is what has got me through my entire life. Anything that I went through, don't be a victim. Own who you are. Love one another. And can I be rude? Can I say something? This is kind of rude. But just remember, everyone's shit is the same color. You're no better than anyone. You need to be separate you from your past.
That's a round of applause again for Richard and me.